this feels good. Okay, we're doing this every day.
Yeah.
Tomorrow.
Thanks, guys.
It's a thriller in Manila.
We're cold plunging.
Look how red it is.
But I paid him back.
Call me Brad.
That's all.
Good.
Is he? Hey.
What's your appointment?
Your family.
You're the only one on your phone.
Where am I? You're like wise with these apps.
You look so stupid.
If you stop worrying about what Pat Riley called peripheral opponents, that is things that just aren't right in front of you, and you live fully ensconced in what's happening right now, you might just find more euphoric bliss than you previously suspected.
Diego, happy birthday.
And then they take out the pants that like after this.
Dummy.
You already said it.
Patrona!
Why did you not skin?
Because look who arrived.
Diego's birthday?
This is what you call a California burrito, sans cheese, and sans meat.
Merry little Christmas. Let your days be
bright. Can you just come in here and start filming everything?
Harry Potter wand.
Houses kind of resonate with me though.
What happened to your hand?
I broke my wig.
Can we do one more? All right, what do you think?
In our laughter over our weird laughs, we find the divine there. We can find him in our greatest joys.
Ooh, that was like a second.
My definition of the divine is that he is the absolute hope, the igniter of the ideas that crop up and pop up in our minds, and the hidden magician inside the corporality of hopes materialized. We find God in the conceptual hope and the corporeal hope. He is both the initiator and final destination for the hopes that he inspires, since any thought in our mind that doesn't inspire hope isn't from the divine. Such corporeal hopes burgeoning forth from conceptual hopes lead us back to the origin of the absolute hope that brought soul world into physicality. Thus, he is the original cause that bleeds spirit into matter, thereby mediating between the disparities.
Who? Everyone.
I'm so good at balancing with one arm.
What?
That's bad.
I love you, buddy.